Students. So today we will start with the second sensory organ, that is the human ear. So let's get started. So this is this anatomical structure of the human ear. You can see the various parts like the outer ear, middle ear, inner ear, and so many cartilages, some canals. We will discuss about this inside. Okay, so there are mainly two sensory organs of human body, okay, which works on the information carried by the waves. The one we have already done yesterday, that is the eye, and now the second one is the ear. So ear is an organ for hearing, as you all know. Without ear, we can't hear anything. Okay, so it is divided into mainly three parts called the outer ear, which contain pinna or the auricle and the auditory canal, the middle ear, which contains the eardrum, ossicles, eustachian tube, and the inner ear, which contains the cochlea, vestibule, and semicircular canal. So this is how we divide the ear into the three sections. The gold one is the outer ear, the pink one is the middle ear, and the blue one is the inner ear. Okay, so the outer ear. The outer ear is similar to a radio wave receiving umbrella of the satellites. We all are having dish TV in our homes, and there is a dish, the umbrella, which is being fixed on the rooftops. So it is actually looked like the same, because the curved formation on the outside is the pinna, which helps to fill out the funnel inside the ear canal, which reaches to the eardrum. Okay, so what is the pinna? It is the main area which receives the waves, the sound waves that travels through the auditory canal or the ear canal. The ear canal or the auditory canal is a funnel, okay, which receives the waves, okay, and it's own length is 2.5 centimeter, and after receiving the waves, it passes them to the eardrum. Okay, it is not only passing the waves to the eardrums, but is also protecting the eardrum from any type of shock or being hit by the outer objects. Okay, so the middle ear, which transfers the energy of sound wave into the vibrations and then pass it on to the bones present in the ear. Okay, so the middle ear contains, number one is the eardrum, which is a cone shaped piece of skin about 10 millimeter wide. Okay, a very sensitive area of your ear. Okay, and if there is slight increase in the pressure outside, there will be the vibration caused inside the eardrum. Okay, so it separates the outer ear from the middle ear. Okay, so it also contains ossicles. The ossicles is the chain, or you can say a flexible chain of the three different parts or three different bones called malleus or the hammer. It is a, why we call it a hammer, because it is a Latin word malleus, and it's mean a tiny bone which produces vibration when there is a increase in pressure. Okay, then comes the anvil or the incus. This is the tiniest bone that passes those vibration from the hammer to the next part, that is the stapes. Okay, the stapes or the stirrups, they are U-shaped bones which passes the vibrations after taking from the incus to the cochlea. Okay, this is also the smallest bone in our human body, ranges 0.25 to 0.33 centimeter only. Okay, now comes the eustachian tube. This is a tube that connects the middle ear and the nose, back of the nose. Why they are joining, why they are having the same, this specific structure because it equalizes the pressure between the middle ear and the outer ear. When you are traveling to the higher altitudes on the mountains, sometimes your ears close and you need to take high breaths, okay, deep breaths. Why you are taking those deep breaths? Because your eustachian tube, when you take the deep breaths, it's open up the congestion in your ear. Okay, now the inner ear, which is divided into two parts. The one is cochlea and the other is auditory nerve. Now the cochlea, it is a spiral tube, okay, and it contains a number of hair cells attached to the end of the organ, okay, and this is called as the organ of Corti. Okay, it also includes auditory nerve. This is the cochlear hair cells, and they are very small and they are bent because the vibration caused by the sound waves. Okay, next is the auditory nerve. Very tiniest hair cells of the cochlea, they produce the motion and producing the vibrations. These vibrations then stimulated the nerve cells, and then these nerve cells sends the signals through the auditory nerves to the brain. Okay, and finally we comes to balancing. Okay, the only purpose of ear is not to hear something, but its other function is to maintain the balance. Okay, who maintains the balance? The semicircular canals. These are the loops, three loops of fluid fills with the fluid, okay, and they are attached to the cochlea inside the ear. Okay, and because of the pressure, when it is high pressure or low pressure, though, that liquid actually helps to maintain the sense of balancing. Okay, now if we summarize whatever we have learned today, is the human ear working, it is in such a way that the sound waves, they travel from the outer ear to the middle ear, then transfer or transmitted to the inner ear, and in the form of compressional waves. These compressional wave, when they reach inner ear, they gets converted into electrical impulses, and then that is being taken up by the brain through the auditory nerve. So this is how we can hear various types of sounds. So that's it. Thank you. Thank you very much.